Bitch, I'm bored.
See you guys next video.
Yeah, try it, Lou! Go it! Try it! What are you doing? What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, and I got Troyce with me today, and we are going to be dragging your favorite YouTubers. Now, I asked you guys on Instagram what YouTubers you want us to react to. Now, y'all, why do people know how to follow directions? I specifically asked for YouTubers. Y'all was commenting celebrities and shit and music videos. Like, no, we're not trying to get copyrighted. We're not doing no music, okay? So we chose most of the YouTubers. Most of the YouTubers either I've watched and he hasn't watched, or he's watched and I haven't watched. And some of these YouTubers, we haven't watched at all, okay, ever. Or we haven't watched in a very long time. Just to preface this, if y'all hear something in the background, it's the motherfucking washing machine. Niggas is washing clothes, last day in New Orleans. So, yeah, sorry. Stop. If you are watching this and you are in this video and we say something disrespectful or something you don't like,
good bitch,
you'll get over it. So, first person on the list, I haven't watched him in a while, but I am still subscribed, and that is Mac Does It. I enjoy his videos. I think they're okay. Like, I think they're pretty entertaining. He does a lot of Ken Burns, which is very interesting because he's been doing that like before the Ember Chamberlain and shit like that. Like, this was his editing style, to be honest.
Yeah, for the past like 2 years, people were steady saying they want to be Ember.
Right. It's funny. It's like, no, there's a lot of people. I've been using Ken Burns before Ember Chamberlain came out. Like, I use it all the time. But this man abuses the fuck out of Ken Burns. That's what I remember. So let's see. What should we click on? I don't know. What should we react to, Troyce?
I mean, we should react to the shortest video possible.
You ain't shit. Alright, let's do exposing Twitter while dressed like a baby.
Bitch! Let's do this. Freaking news. So being the millennial generation Z I am, needing constant connection to the world, as soon as I woke up in the morning, I log on to Twitter. That's simple. That's normal. That's like a regular thing everyone does in the world nowadays.
So one
glorious morning, shall we say. I wake up through the day that I'm still alive.
Bitch, I'm bored. See you guys next video.
Yeah, try it, Lou! Go it! Try it! What are you doing? What was wrong with the video?
It was boring.
That was just a lot. It's everywhere.
I feel like YouTube, people who watch YouTube have ADD, and it's like, if you don't impress me like in the first 25, 30 seconds, I'm out.
Okay, shall we move along to the next person?
Like, to the point. I think how he said, what's good, y'all? So today I'm gonna be reacting to stupid ass fucking stupid tweets, and I'm gonna be getting to this, like, I feel like you should've just got straight to the point instead of saying, guys, so I was just scrolling through Twitter, you know, being regular, you know, that's what everybody always does. Ken Burn, jump cut, Ken Burn. So yeah, I was scrolling through Twitter, and then, you know, Twitter, people be on Twitter, you know.
All right, next one is Beam Squad. Beam Squad. Yeah, I like Mac Does It, but.
No shade.
Oh well. The Beam Squad is the next victim here. The thing is, I heard about Beam Squad, I heard they're Haitian. That's the only reason people have brought them to my attention. But I could never get past their fucking intro.
Yeah, they went to high school with me.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Well, not with me. I actually went to the same high school and I knew their sister.
Oh, wow.
They just copy and paste that damn kid over their thumbnails and channels. Sheesh. Y'all better get them views. Get that lingerie. Secure the valise.
Oh, my water broke prank on Panton Squad? What the fuck is Panton Squad?
Sounds like a fucking STD.
Shut up! I can't get into the whole couple family channel thing.
I'm not personally a couple channel person.
Very rare.
The channel I watched was Damo and Chrissy. And the last couple channels I'm subscribed to is Jamie and Nikki, but they're boring as fuck.
No, I subscribed to Kwesi and Alicia. K&A.
Yeah, K&A. I mean,
and then I feel like there's like literally a handful that I actually like. Like Jeff Vlogs, I don't know if you've watched them before. I like them. And then there's another
Slice
one.
Slice and Rice.
Slice and Rice. Shout out to y'all. Love them. There's a couple of them I like, but I can't usually get into them. But let's pick something. Let's see. Super Saiyan fell off the ATV prank. That shit got a million views.
How many views it has?
A million.
What's it called again?
Super Saiyan fell off the ATV prank. Wasn't YouTube banning videos that show children in distress?
People exploit their kids for views, but hey, if it's you, it pays the bills. You had to exploit that damn kid. Just filming this thing anyways.
What it is,
oh, wow. They cut up the intro.
Yeah, thank God.
Today we're doing a new prank.
Yeah, we're about to prank mommy. We're gonna act like Super Saiyan fell off the ATV.
Oh, we got a heavy ass Haitian accent. We're about to prank mommy.
What? We're about to get her back. That she thought, you know, because you know she could be pregnant. She didn't mean that we're gonna get her back. Hey, we're gonna get mommy. We're gonna get her big this time.
Yeah.
Mommy.
Guys, I got a little bit of
fake blood right now. So,
we're Haitian. Not the Haitian flag.
Right now, she's editing a video, one of our videos upstairs right now. And I told her I'm gonna be out here riding the ATVs with Messiah. So, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna try to see where I can find a set of the camera somewhere out here. I don't know where I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna figure it out. And I'm gonna act like Super Saiyan fell off, and I'm gonna run inside. Thing is, when I run inside, I'm gonna put Super Saiyan like in one of the cars. I'm gonna tell Super Saiyan hide in the car. So I'm like, hold on, Super Saiyan was just here. Like, the ATV is gonna be sideways or whatever, there's gonna be blood on the floor. I'm like, what the hell happened to Super Saiyan? Where's Super Saiyan?
Okay, thanks.
There you go. Let's fast forward.
Maybe they're pajamas.
Hit that little bell.
I'm sorry, they got a little
bruh, people really out here having their kids know these damn their lines. Y'all might as well start naming y'all kids like, comment, and subscribe.
Yo, I'm fucking dead. What the fuck,
kid?
He's too cute though.
We missed it.
Oh, we missed it.
Go inside and go scream, okay?
Yeah,
go. Stay in here. When I come, when you see us coming out, duck so mommy can't see you. Alright, good. Hey! Hey! Super Saiyan fell off the ATV! Super Saiyan fell! Come on! Super Saiyan fell off the ATV, babe!
Y'all call their they call their son Super Saiyan.
He fell! Come on!
Yeah, Super Saiyan.
Come on!
Tell him to get up. Yo, what the fuck? That's something I would say. I can't even be bad.
Come on. He's over there on the floor.
That's a lot of angles. How the hell did they do that?
That's not even real, like, come on now.
Right.
So you ran to me to tell me to come pick him up? Why the you bitch, you ain't got hands?
I'm confused.
This is literally NyQuil.
I'm bored. I mean, I guess if that's what y'all like, it ain't for us.
That's what I like. I mean, hey, most of the fans are kids, so it's like, I'm not even mad at them. I think it's more so if I was 8, I'd probably enjoy watching this. I just don't like pranks, because I know most of them are fake, and I think that's what turned me off about this, is that you could tell it's fake.
Right.
More so because it's, he fell, the baby fell.
Like, what was that? I'm sorry, that was trash. I don't
like, you,
but it got a million views, so congrats. Not for me.
No.
I want to take my view back. Comments are disabled.
they didn't even do nothing to their damn kid. The kid just sat in the fucking car.
Maybe because she's pregnant. They were like, why would you do that, you know, to a pregnant woman? You know, you don't shop pregnant people. You shouldn't do that. But I'm sure it was fake anyway. Anyways, next, De'Ara and Ken. That was my most requested one.
Ew.
I've never watched any of their videos except for when that whole controversy happened where homeboy cheated on her or supposedly cheated on her.
Yeah, I still think he cheated on her.
Me too.
After that scandal, I couldn't watch no more. I was like, bro, this is weird, y'all, it's weird. I'm sure they're happy, but nah, like that whole scandal just turned me off. Like, it just seemed like it was covering shit up.
Right.
They just don't interest me as much as they used to.
Right.
And plus, they constantly started getting repetitive and annoying. It's like, I do the same old challenges and pranks and over-exaggerated reactions. It's like, maybe they're good for kids, just not for me. I don't think anyone younger than 16 can find them entertaining.
What up, DK Gang?
Hey, we are back with another!
Why the fuck is she so loud, first and foremost?
I'm loud too.
Yeah. Okay, she looks good. The little highlighter wig, it looks good.
Freaking video! Really good. Oh yeah, that's too much. That's too fucking much. She dead ass. She dead ass.
Just for that, I'm fucking up your watch.
It was
like
a spider.
Yeah, that's
a spider,
y'all. I got what do you call spider webs? If we bought this and they ain't give us no discount, yeah, we're gonna have to take this back so we get a discount.
They're really popping, y'all. They're really good. There's no black popper channel doing as good as them.
They're cute.
Alright, so we have got our fish tanks filled with water, and we are going to rock, paper, scissors to see who's going to, you know, go first with dipping their hands in the water. Best two out of three.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Okay. Y'all know Deer be cheating.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
That's good.
No.
You don't know how to play rock, paper, scissors, shoot, bitch? What was that?
I feel like they're exaggerated, their reactions are so exact. I don't know. Maybe they're just naturally goofy. I think that's what it is. I don't know. I haven't watched them in a year. I haven't watched them in a very long time.
Some people like to watch.
What's so entertaining about this?
This shit got 3 million views. What the fuck?
Next.
Alright. I don't hate them. I don't love them. I don't understand what I just watched, but that was a waste of my goddamn time.
People are emotionally draining me. I'm like, exhausted.
Someone said we should react to Lissetti. I didn't even know she still had a channel. I've never watched her. I think I have actually, back in the day.
Her videos are like ASMR. They didn't call me nobody lit or interesting.
These are supposed to be lit or interesting people.
I don't care for none of these people.
Listen,
I know who all of them are. Don't get so I know who all of them are, but I don't care for none of them. I'm not interested. I feel like a lot of people don't have personality, or I feel like they just exaggerate.
Well, say you don't have personality? I wouldn't know. I don't remember.
I mean, De'Ara can't got personality, but they're just boring. Like, it's like, damn, like, y'all, it's up a little bit. Let's get some constructive criticism. Mac does it, what if I get for him?
Less Ken Burns.
Less
a lot. That's just a lot. Stop. It wasn't boring.
Boring.
It was just too much going on.
Next YouTube we watched, he ended up watching who?
Beam Squad.
My advice for Beam Squad. Anyways, I mean, y'all got a whole kid follow fan base anyways, but I mean, y'all kid not gonna be cute forever.
Yeah.
So.
You gotta find another avenue.
They get on that pole. Hi, Popeyes.
And then, who did we just watch? DK4O,
what advice do I give to them? I mean, I feel like they need to mix it up a little bit. Like, they've been doing challenges prank for a very long time. And it's like, it gets repetitive after a while. Because
it's honestly still getting new views.
I feel like it's repetitive in my opinion. I feel like if y'all gonna do something, like, you know, mix it up a little bit. You know, dibble and dabble. I feel like if they're gonna do challenges and stuff, incorporate fans into your challenges, or incorporate fans and do a whole, if you win you get $500, do crazy shit, like do a Fear Factor challenge, do a Silent Library challenge type shit, you know, mix it up, do a do a speed dating challenge. Do something like funny, do something goofy. Mm-hmm. Like step outside the box if you're gonna do challenges. Like, are you really just gonna sit up there and do eating challenges all the time? Or do touching stuff challenges? But come on now, like that's just corny. I don't know.
I agree.
I feel like your fans are growing with you. It's like a lot of these people who are fans of you have been watching y'all for years, and eventually they're gonna grow out of you.
Honestly, I can't find not one Lucetti video that either one of us would be interested in.
Let's see.
It's all basic bitch shit.
Oh my god.
And I've been scrolling forever. We're all the way at the end of her freaking
really
channel.
Boring.
Like, and we didn't even click on shit yet.
Who's the next YouTuber?
Oh yeah, stop. We can't skip her like that.
Nah, skip.
Come on. We gotta do something. Alright, let's try 10 embarrassing TMI hygiene tips.
Hey guys, it's Lisette here. I feel like I have transformed with makeup, to be honest. Because I haven't like done glam in so long that when I do glam, it's like, oh, like, okay.
I don't care, bitch.
It's me multiple times. I mean, I know people don't like pooping in public.
She's already on number three.
Your arms, and it honestly really truly works. But if that doesn't work for you, you can actually get Botox under your arms, which they literally inject.
Don't nobody can afford Botox.
Back, girl sweat, underarms, like the groin area, like especially down there. I feel like it can get really kind of like sweaty. It actually makes spray for downstairs. Now, you don't want to put spray inside your body. You don't want to put anything inside. You don't want to open.
Okay. Next person.
If I was thinking Lisette is.
You know, she reminds me of the older channels. Like back in the day. This is the shit that people used to do back in the day. I just can't get into it. I would not subscribe.
She still gets a lot of views. How many subscribers does she have? Oh, she's still doing pretty good.
Yeah, she's doing pretty well. So I guess
I really know she's making coin, because these natural hair people who promote shampoos and like hair products and all this stuff and makeup and stuff.
It's just boring to me. I can't get into it. Yeah, she's just boring. She's generic. I see nothing special about her content. This is the same content I was watching back in high school.
Yeah.
I don't see anything that's changed with her shit at all. But I mean, it's working for you, so hey, fuck it.
I don't really have any advice for her. I feel like she's getting consistent views. She has too many subscribers. She's doing perfectly fine, honestly.
Yeah, she's doing good, I guess.
She's doing fine. And then her views are straight to the point. They're not too long. Like, look, 12 minute, 5 minute, 13 minute, 8 minute, 14 minute. Like, she does what she wants. Like, she does what she needs to do. And she gives advice and she delivers very nicely. I just think she's fucking boring.
Right.
She's just as boring as watching old paint dry. She's horrendous.
Are Fabulous? You ever heard of that person? Miss R Fabulous? My Jamaican Yardie mom caught me piping.
What the hell is this?
I've never heard of her. Miss R Fabulous. That seemed interesting. I'm watching that.
22, man.
Hello?
No, 22, not 42.
22.
Mom!
Hi.
Your food!
Where is he?
Okay, you bust number 22.
22.
Bruv, I said 22. What number? Why did you keep. Can't you understand?
What does this have to do with the video? Intros annoy me.
Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Miss R Fabulous. I'm back with another video. And guys, can I get a round of applause? Guys, can everybody just give me a clap? Your girl is back with another story time video. And I just want to let you guys know I've got another story time coming after this story time. And you guys know that I love telling a story time. That's just I'm just a storyteller. But don't ever get it twisted. My story times are real. My story times are real life shit. I don't make story times up like some people do for clout. Some people really be making up stories for them views, baby. Me, I'm natural. I don't have to do that, baby. And you know, yeah, there's no story time that I tell without not having a liquor in my blood clot.
I like her too.
Which is fucking I'm subscribing.
Champagne bottles, baby, like. But I'm not gonna lie, I was going for a stage where I loved men company, like I loved men attention. And I'm not gonna say men because at the time there was there was boys like I was 16 or 17 years old, I believe I was. Yeah, I was 16, I was in school uniform. But obviously, I finished school now.
Wow, this is the longest we've watched this video without skipping.
She went through a stage where she was boy crazy in high school. Were you boy crazy in high school?
I wouldn't say I was boy crazy, but I liked boy attention, just like what she's saying. Like, I craved the attention.
You would wear, like, your shirt with your cleavage out so they would notice you?
Not really. I didn't do all of that at all. I did used to dress really nice to catch people's attention.
Did you go
I still dress nice. It's not really to get attention. I just really like dressing nice.
Yeah, because you want to feel good. If you dress like shit,
yeah,
you feel
look
less
good,
confident.
You feel good. That's one of my quotes that I live by. This video is too damn long.
But we
can't react to all of this. Yeah, we can't react to all of this. I'm definitely gonna watch this on my free time.
I'm gonna watch it too. She's entertaining. You gotta all right to watch.
That's the best thing we watch. That's sad as fuck.
Advice I'm gonna give her? Huh? I don't really have no advice. She's doing good. You know what you're doing.
Yeah, too much of a long intro though. If you're gonna do an hair review, you gotta get more to the point. Like, you can't do a hair review and be popping bottles and then talking about that and then you can't. That's too much.
And then shouting out Rick Ross. Rick Ross ain't gonna see this video.
Yeah, like that's too much. But I really liked her. Sam and Colby, lovely peaches.
Sam and Colby, I remember them.
Who the fuck are they?
I can show you a video right now that is literally gonna make you like look at them like, damn.
Sam and Colby.
Damn, these white people. I'm obsessed with Colby. He's funny as shit.
Okay, things are going to change. Oh, this is one of those
clickbait sad videos.
Right.
White boy and white boy.
Mm-hmm. What's up, guys? Sam and Colby.
It's been a while. We're back.
How did you make it? You're tight. White, rich white boys, famous.
Trip. Which is which? This is Sam and this is Colby?
Situation.
Sam, Colby. And
that
Colby's kind of cute.
Go silent on social media. We just want to say
first
off,
beautiful eyes.
Sorry.
Look how icy them shits are.
Yeah.
Cut that damn hair, bro. That shit looks
we were told by management and our team to lay low for a little bit, so I hope you guys understand.
Why?
But, hey.
Weird.
I'm saying why they lean low.
Yeah! You guys might be wondering what the heck happened, why we left social media. A bunch of questions need to be answered, and we will do our best to
answer
all of
them. That's
why I
said I thought they were
so
broken up.
Answers stay.
But
however, we cannot get into the details of our situation that happened in Florida.
That's what they started. They had a joint Vine account.
Everything is
solved. Had 5 million followers.
Let you guys
hear
know that that's
they broke
not
up.
Going to happen for a couple months. When
then
that happens, we'll tell you guys everything that happened in detail, but until then,
gotta zip it.
We're just gonna move on.
So that being said, this is our first video back, obviously, and we're also going to start posting on our personal channels as well, and Instagram, Twitter, all of our socials, but we're
honestly,
not going to be talking about our situation
shit.
At all, so
they
if you guys can please
do
not ask any questions
stuff.
About it, so we can
they just
move
do
on, that would
weird,
be amazing.
Weird
honestly,
shit.
If you guys are in the comments trying to tell people what happened, starting rumors, that's only going to hurt us.
Yeah.
So please, just like, if you do one thing for us, at least for the time being, don't say anything. Don't think you know what happened because no one really knows what happened. With all that being said, we are okay. Like, trust me, it was a nightmare of a situation.
I don't like
okay,
people doing that.
Don't
talk about your situation and not
like, how the
fuck
are you gonna clickbait and say we're gonna talk about it and then not talk about
it? Well, they didn't say that. They just said things are going to change. That's the name of the video.
Okay, next.
All right. Next YouTuber.
Lovely Peaches.
I've heard of this Lovely Peaches, but I don't know what she's about.
I just sold my 9-month-old baby to a grown-ass man and sex trafficking for $150. Fuck that bitch. I woke up this morning and there was this little ant inside me.
Are you serious?
Yeah. But you know how female problems are. If you were a female, you would understand. Trust me.
Have you ever had ants in your vagina? She said she woke up with ants inside of her. Is that like a normal thing? You just wake up with a ant farm in your vagina? Ant hill in your vagina? Is that normal?
I don't even know why you're asking me that, Trace.
That's a serious vagina. I mean, is that bad?
Do you have ants crawling out of your penis, Trace? I don't even understand what you're asking me right now.
She said female problems.
Roaches, ants, spiders, all types of things.
Oh my god, you lying.
Termites,
you lying.
You think I'm a piece of wood?
be the worst thing I've ever reacted to. Okay.
Oh, you've seen enough?
I've seen enough. Next person, belief in fatherhood. Never heard of them. When I learned from my kids' frustration, live stream dad said, my friends just like I said, teaches me about this. Okay, these titles
are boring.
Hell.
I'm sleep. I wanna go to sleep after seeing some of this shit.
Yeah, these thumbnails are not good either. The book we love to read every night. That's such a terrible fucking title.
Prayers.
Oh my god, these kids are so freaking cute.
Hey buddies. Buddies! It's bedtime now. Hey buddies. Buddies.
Oh, these little kids are so freaking cute.
Now. Hey buddies.
Oh wow. Cute chocolate babies.
Oh my god. I need my kids to look like that.
Yes. Hey, beautiful black family.
Okay, then we can sing prayers. If you like this video, make sure you mollywop that like button and share it to all your friends and
make sure you get sleep and get your poop on your butt.
I'm done.
He's there for his kids and everything.
That's all I love.
Yo, thank you guys so much for watching today. I believe you're watching Belief for Fatherhood. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this.
This is so cute.
Yeah, I love this.
What a beautiful chocolate man.
Yes. Shut the hell up.
Remember that from White Chicks?
Yes.
What a beautiful chocolate man.
You're going to suck. These kids are freaking adorable. I love this.
Video, make sure that you mollywop that like button if you are fortunate
enough to be doing like this. I haven't heard that one in a long time. I used to say it all the time.
With them.
Where is he from? Talk about some mollywop.
Or watch it with them. Alright? I'm gonna read this book now. This is our book. It's bedtime now. If you want to purchase this book, you're welcome to do that on our website, belieffatherhood.com. Now we're gonna go ahead and get this bedtime. Hold on. Look at this. This is your brother's picture. Protect this. Protect your life, boy. Alright. Here we go. You protect your life. Thank you guys so much for watching. Protect your life. You can never probably see you next time. Peace.
What? That's it? First of all, I'm verified on fucking Instagram.
Wow. Even though they should have been in their beds, they laughed.
47
And pulled out all their sheets. Whispered their favorite songs, trying not to make a peep.
Mom went into
the room and said, what are you doing up?
Alright, I'm not about to watch this, but I think this is super cute. I wouldn't subscribe to it.
It's really cute though.
Just because I'm not into the family channel thing, I'm not into the couple channel thing. People keep trying to convince me otherwise, and it's like, it's very rare for me to actually really like one of these channels and subscribe and dedicate my time to watching them. It's not terrible. I might follow on Instagram though, because these kids are so freaking cute, and I can't freaking deal. Like, this is a really cute family. I like cute families. I don't know. Maybe I will follow on Instagram. But yeah, please do your thumbnails. And your titles better, cause this was the most. I can't. These titles were boring. Titles are boring. The thumbnails are trash. I'm sorry. Key Casanova. Haven't watched her in a while.
She's so pretty, but she's so fucking boring.
I wouldn't say she's boring. I just would say she just has a hard time capturing an audience. Oh, I thought she gave up her channel. Wasn't she supposed to sell it?
Of course, you know, that money and rent's due on the first.
Let's see.
She's really chill though, but she stays on fucking live. I don't follow her. Like, I don't know her.
Oh,
live.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh my god. If she go live one more time.
Chuck E. Cheese theory. Okay, so she's trying to get back on her grind.
She's really pretty though. She's insanely pretty. I'm like, wow, I cannot believe how pretty this girl is.
Let's see her Chuck E. Cheese video. Seen a lot of people doing these.
Wow, she's really expanding her content. She's trying to go to the white side of YouTube.
Trust me, if you don't shut the hell up.
Nah. Nah.
Ooh, I should record a high
end. Nah. Like, I can't believe this. I really can't.
Would you rather throw that shit away?
They're not answering the phone. It just said thank you for calling and I hung up like they know why I'm coming.
Got up on my Birkin, it's working. She said she a virgin, it's hurting. She ain't never show me love when my pocket's hurting. Now she see a nigga on, she fuck.
What song is this?
See me putting on, my pocket, it's working.
I actually like that song. I believe this is leaked by Lil J. Okay, leaked by Lil DJ. Listen, thank you for putting me on key. Cause what?
Yeah, thank you for that shit on my music too.
I think I have one Lil TJ song on here.
Never heard of him.
It was giving me A Boogie vibes. I thought it was A Boogie. Yeah, I was like, really thought it was, but something was off. That's what I'm like, that ain't my baby. But that was cute.
And then they see me put it on and they got the nervous. We'll never need a born, I did it on purpose.
Yo. What is poppin' Nation? It is your girl Kikasno and I'm back with another YouTube video. Now, the video that I'm doing today is kind of interesting. I don't think I would ever have done this on my channel, but you know, last night I watched Shane Dawson's conspiracy theory video about Chuck E. Cheese. Now, you do know that I am from Canada and he's in America, and I kind of want to see if Chuck E. Cheese is the same in Canada as it is in the United States. So me and Shanae are going to Chuck E. Cheese right now. If those who have not watched the video, I will link the video down below. It is a very interesting video. I watched the whole hour and 34 minutes. Swear to God, I'm gonna link it down below. Basically, the theory is that Chuck E. Cheese recycles pizza. So say I got pizza and I ate 6 slices out of the 8, then they took the 2 slices and threw it on someone else's pizza. So I'm about to show you some of the pictures.
I love you and all, but I'm gonna have to skip to the pizza because I don't care.
But catch it, it's uneven.
Yeah, it's uneven.
They're definitely reusing pizzas.
Oh my god.
It's uneven though. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
Wow,
it's crazy.
I cannot
believe this right now.
Oh. Yo, we should've did this.
We should just brought my bacon instead.
Oh my god.
What?
Nah.
It should've been on my bacon.
Nah, bro.
That would've been on that trash ass food we ate.
Yeah.
No, don't even touch it. Don't even touch it. I can't even believe my eyes, but the only thing different about this pizza is the lines match up. The lines really match up, but yeah, we finished the cheesy bread.
Wow.
You can call me nasty
bitch
on my hair. I tried
it.
It
tasted a little
fresh.
Just a little bit.
Shane started a whole new way.
Yeah, he did.
Now
Chuck E.
Cheese looks really bad.
I swear to God. I took 2 slices, but look at it. What is this?
That's insane.
This doesn't even make...
Honestly?
How is that possible? Like, I have no idea. But I looked over there to the people, and both of the body people stared at me, and then all of them just looked at me. Even Chucky. Look, Chucky's like looking at us, but like...
Yo, what the hell? Yo, that's some creepy ass shit. I ain't fucking with that.
She's entertaining though. That's pretty much enough. I feel like we didn't even realize that we were reacting to it.
Yeah. I actually like this video. Good job.
I might resubscribe.
I'm not. She's just inconsistent and I don't like that shit. I mean, it looked like she getting back on her grind, but you had this whole situation where you're like, oh, I'm still on my channel. I'm over it. I don't like that whole I'm taking a break. I can't do it.
Yeah, you come back.
No. I'm sorry, you lost me. We only like one person. And, I mean, I still like Mac does it.
I don't like Key Casanova.
Yeah, I liked Key. That's I watched her before. And then that new RF Fabulous. Miss RF Fabulous.
RF Fabulous.
Yeah, you got a new subscriber in me, bitch.
She's
this
the only one I might subscribe to.
Yeah, this is very interesting. I might fuck around and do more of these. Let me know. This video might fuck around and get us in trouble. I feel like somebody's gonna get
offended. They might react to it.
Ooh. It is what it is, though. We said what the fuck we said. Don't take it personal.
It's our opinion.
Just critiquing.
Our opinions are like assholes. We all have them.
Right.
It's like assholes. Some like dicks in there, some like popsicles exactly. in there, some like lollipops in there.
Let me know what you think about this video and sound in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe to me and you subscribe to Troyce. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I will see y'all next time.